structured evolutionary prototyping model. We shall discuss this software development paradigm into more details. So developers build a prototype during the requirement phase. So at first the prototype will be built. Prototype means the miniature version of the software where the main functionalities will only remain implemented. Prototype is evaluated by the end users. So the prototype will be demonstrated or they may be allowed to use it, and then we shall be taking the feedbacks from them. So prototype is evaluated by the end users. So evaluation will be done by the end users, and users give corrective feedback. So what they wanted, what they didn't get in the prototype. So all the corrective feedbacks will be accumulated and will be obtained from the users. Developers further refine the prototype. So prototype will go for the next version. When the user is satisfied, the prototype code is brought up to the standards needed for the final product. When the prototype is getting finalized, then from that concept, the final software will be developed for the users. So this is the basic concept in our structured evolutionary prototyping model. So what are the steps we are having? A preliminary project plan is developed. A partial high-level paper model is created. The model is sourced for a partial requirements specification. Because I told you that only the main features of the software will remain implemented. So obviously this model is a source for a partial requirements specification. A prototype is built with basic and critical attributes. The designer builds the database, user interface and algorithmic functions. The designer demonstrates the prototype. The user evaluates for problems and suggests some improvements. And this loop continues until the user is getting satisfied. So these are the steps to be followed in this prototyping model. So now here we are having the strengths of prototyping model. How does evolutionary prototyping help customers and developers? So this is the question. So customers can see the system requirements as they are being gathered, and developers learn from the customers through their feedbacks, constructive and positive, negative both. How are new requirements dealt with? So this is the question. So here in case of prototyping model, unexpected requirements accommodated and allow for flexible design and development from the feedback of the client. So sometimes a client can make one requirement which was not mentioned at the early stage of our requirement gathering, but that requirement may also get implemented in the current version. How can additional needed functionality be identified? So this is a question. Answer is interaction with the prototype, simultaneous awareness of the additional needed functionality. So these are the respective strengths of this prototyping model. So now let us go for the respective weaknesses. What is the risk involved with this model? Overall maintainability may be overlooked and process may continue forever. So now what is happening, you see, at first we are having, during the requirement gathering phase, we are having some set of requirements. We have developed the software in the prototype. In the prototyping model, we have implemented the basic functionalities and some critical functionalities. Now, when the prototype will be given to the user for their uses, the user will give some feedbacks out of that. And some new requirements may also be coming from the users. As a result of that, as those new requirements are supposed to get incorporated in the present version of the software, so sometimes the maintainability of the software may get overlooked. So when you are implementing new requirements which were not suggested at the very initial stage, so now you are trying to implement the new requirements in the same developed form of the software, maintainability may remain overlooked. And this process may go forever because your client, your customer may become too much innovative, too much experimental, too much judgmental. So they just go on giving their requirements and judgments and feedbacks, so the process may continue forever. So that is one of the very disadvantage of this prototyping model. So now next one is the when to use this prototyping model. Requirements are unsuitable or have to be clarified. At the requirements clarification stage of a waterfall model, developed user interface, short-lived demonstrations. In those cases, in case of short-lived demonstration, the prototyping model can be implemented. To develop some user interface, you can get the client's requirement and you can develop it and you can get the client's feedback on it. New original development, and then with the analysis and design portions of object-oriented development. So these are the cases where this prototyping model can be implemented. Thanks for watching this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.